Hello everyone. In this video, you will learn how to execute actions during form load in Zoho Creator. A form is a collection of fields that let you collect information from users. What to do when you want actions such as pop-up messages or auto-populating fields with values from other forms to occur when a form loads? That's where the form event, Lord of the Form, comes into use in Zoho Creator. You can configure actions using deluge to execute during the form load. This can be used in multiple instances such as fetching and auto-populating the name and employee ID from another form based on employee's login details, or displaying the latest value of gold by comparing it with the international market value in an application for a jewelry store, or sharing the remaining seats available while booking tickets for a movie, and many more. Let's try to understand this better with the help of a real-time use case. This is a sample application for employee management. In this form, employees can apply for leave. We already have an employees form where basic information of all employees is stored. The requirement is to fetch the name, employee ID and email from this form and auto-populate them on the apply leave form based on the employee who logs in. In addition, let's disable these fields to restrict access to the end users. Let's see how to do it. Go to the editor and select the workflow section. Click New Workflow. Choose the form in which you wish to run the workflow. Let's choose Apply Leave. Select Created or Edited as the record event since we want the values to be populated at both events. Our requirement is to fetch and populate values when the form loads. So, choose Load of the Form. Give a name and click Create Workflow. Let's add actions to it. The actions to be triggered on Load of the Form can be executed only with delute script. This is the delute script builder. The logic we define here gets executed when the apply leave form loads every time a record is created or edited. Our requirement is to fetch records from the employee's form and populate them on the apply leave form based on the employee who logs in. Once this is done, these fields need to be disabled. Let's do it one by one. Whenever you need to fetch data from another form or app, the fetch records task is used. You can either drag and drop or directly type the code. Let's declare a variable getValues and match the email ID in the employee's form with the ID of the employee who logs in. Type getValues equals. Choose the form from which you need to fetch the data. The All Employees report is created from the employee's form. Type employees. The official email equals zoho.login.userid semicolon. Here, we have matched the official mail ID from the employee's form with the employee's login ID. The record that corresponds to the official email ID in the employee form will be stored in this variable. Next, let's auto-populate the values in the apply leave form. Type input.employeeID equals getValues.employeeID semicolon. Here, the employee ID field of apply leave form is populated with the employee ID available in the getValues variable. Similarly, we can auto-populate other fields such as name and email address with the data available in the getValues variable. Now that the fetch and auto-population are ready, let's proceed to disable these fields here itself. You can refer to the fielding names from the refer field section as well. Type disable employee ID semicolon, disable name semicolon, disable email semicolon. You can also disable the fields using point and click actions by defining field rules. Check out our detailed video about this to gain a better understanding. Let's save the code and access the application to see what happens. When the form loads, based on the login ID, the values are populated and the access to these fields is denied. As you can see, these values match the values in the report. In this way, you can configure actions to execute when the form loads as per your requirement. Hope you got a good understanding of this concept. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about Zoho Creator and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video releases. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next video.